Right, so the idea is that if I can somehow, let's just say, hang on a minute, I'll get this off of there first. Somehow put a camera on here, look down, and I want to see if there's a way where I can actually clean out the people's gutters, because there seems to be quite a lot of, let's just say, residue mud kind of left over. And if I can try and get it out, because a lot of the time it's kind of stuck. I'm trying to get that little thing out of there, but I don't think I can, but I'll try it without it, I think. Let's see how we get on with it. It needs to be like that, doesn't it? So I'll get this set up, stick a camera on there, looking down, and we'll get the jets on it, and lots of water's going to come out. So I just want to see whether it actually starts to clean the gutter, you know, to get rid of the kind of in-ground kind of mud, as it were. I don't know if it's going to do that. Only thing I can do is try. Tighten it back up again. Give me the right angle then. So I'll take this out the front and we'll see how we get on with it. Right, so plug that into there, which is this here, and then all I have to do is to extend it up. What I want is that to get in the right angle if I can, something like that there maybe. Right, so let's turn the camera on, shall we, get filming. I'm going to turn the water on now. Yeah, it's getting in there, that's all right. I can just lift it up slightly, perhaps like that, angle it down a bit, that might work better. Quite tight actually. It's fairly tight. Okay, right, that was just a quick trial really. I'm not sure how effective it was, but I think all I can do is just try, because quite often times what happens is that the residue is actually left, and it's sometimes it's difficult to get out. In fact, you know, extreme cases I could probably do this, I think. There you go. Anyway, stop filming. Okay, right, so I'm on another little job this morning. I've got to do a block paving, jet wash, as someone's block paving. I've run around four different places this morning trying to find a pair of Wellington boots. And two places I went online to said they had them, and when they got there, they didn't have them. So I had to go to other places, and now I just haven't got any. Oh man, there we go. Anyway, I'm gonna get a little bit wet, I think, today. It's gonna rain, I think, plus I'm gonna get absolutely filthy doing this job. But still, it needs to be done, and I'll crack on with it. So that's the old house I used to live in as a child, number 9 Barrington Road. That place was haunted, actually. Okay, there was some paranormal activity which went on in that place, and I might get into that in a later video, but yeah, that was kind of interesting. Some very strange, weird things happened in that house, which I had no explanation for. None of us did. But we all kind of sensed it and saw it as well. Anyway, there we go. Hey, right, a before shot this time, before and after. So this is the driveway I'm gonna be doing. First things first, I'm gonna sweep it off with the brush, and then I'm gonna wet it. Then I'm gonna put some detergent on it, scrub the detergent in, try and get the lichen off, or the lichen. And the moss as well, and then go along with my good old jet wash, and hopefully it'll be done. So hopefully this will take about 4 hours to do, and I'll bring you back at some point to give you an update. Right, so the area's been scrubbed with detergent. I'm gonna let it soak in for a few minutes. Let it do its job, loosen it all up. And then I'm gonna get to it with the jet wash. And then hopefully it'll come out a lot better. Yeah, I might be a bit of a mess. I don't know, am I a mess, Steve?
Not too bad.
Oh, not too bad.
Oh. Is that keys?
Yeah. Okay, so you saw the before, this is the after. What do you reckon, Steve? Is that any good?
That's all. It's a good job, mate.
Yeah. You reckon you're happy with that?
Yeah. It's a good job.
I think we might just need a more powerful jet wash, though. I reckon. Yeah, so what do you think?
Yeah, I think so.
I reckon
about
so.
150 bar or something like that.
Yeah, so a bit, yeah. It'd take a bit less time, I think, but...
Yeah, well, that's the thing, isn't it? You know.
So it's not quite finished yet. I've got to come back and put some sand in it, some kiln dry sand.
Yeah.
It's a bit damp to do it at the moment, plus it might rain or something, but I could come back the weekend and sort that out.
Yeah. Supposed to be nice.
Yeah, that'd be fine. I'll do it tomorrow. Yeah. Tomorrow or Sunday.
Well, any time, yeah. If you ain't got time tomorrow, just a shout when you're coming over. Yeah. We'll clear the driveway for you.
Yeah, yeah. You know. I think I got your number. Now, but I'll get it done the weekend. I'll do nothing on tomorrow or Sunday. So
all right.
Give me something to do. Uh-huh. Escape from the wife for a while. All right, Steve.
Right,
stay in my car, my gosh.
Back
okay. Well, the hose wasn't long enough.
Okay.
That's all right. That's
one
no problem.
Stretchy ones.
Oh, have you?
Right out here, yeah.
Yeah.
Right, sorry, I am a mess, aren't I? I do apologise for that. And I was wearing my protective gear as well. I'm just making sure I've not left anything behind. If I have, I'll come back Sunday, so I've got to come back Sunday and finish off. Yeah, so that was okay. I got here at about 10 o'clock, 11, 12, 1. 3 hours, just over 3 hours, I think. Not too bad, maybe 3.5 actually, thinking about it. So my power unit, it lasted for about, say about an hour, okay, an hour. That's what I got out of that. So then I had to go on electric, mains power. And what I noticed when I put it on mains power, the actual jet wash, it performed better, more powerful. So just something to bear in mind, that one. If I do get myself a more powerful jet wash, then the chances are that my battery pack might not run it. So I've got to be mindful of that. But he's happy with it, I'm happy with it. Got to go back Sunday or tomorrow to finish off. Only got 100 quid. There we go, £100. That's good. And gonna go home now. And we're gonna go and look at the bungalow we're moving into. And the moving date, supposedly 7th of June. So literally a week today, we should be moving, but that might be pushed back a little bit, just because there's one or two little things, spanners in the works, which might stop that from happening. But more updates to come on that one. Anyway, so that's it from me. Thanks for watching. Take care and bye for now. I'm going to have a shower now.